half-blind dovetails. On half-blind dovetails, only one side of the joint shows. For flush or rabbeted drawer fronts, boxes, or cabinetry. The D4R is two dovetail jigs in one. First, a through dovetail jig. Then, simply by turning the finger assembly end over end, it becomes a half-blind dovetail jig. On the pin side, instead of angled guide surfaces on top, there are parallel guide surfaces. The icon on the green scale now clearly shows as a half-blind pin. Simply rotating the finger assembly puts the jig in the half-blind tail mode indicated by the icon. These guide surfaces are similar to through dovetail tail guides. As with through dovetails, the Leigh guide fingers give automatic alignment of pins and tails. So all drawer corners are simply routed at one end of the jig. With fixed template jigs, the pins and tails are always the same size. There's no option for variable joint spacing. With the D4R, you have total freedom of joint design for that elegant hand-cut look. The adjustable guide fingers allow you to design a half pin at each side of all joint layouts, regardless of board width. On template jigs, because the pattern is fixed, there's no guarantee there'll be a half pin at each edge of the joint. Completely variable joint spacing on the D4R solves this problem. Perfect half-blind joints are as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1. Create the joint design. 2. Route the tails. 3. Route the pins. Half-blind tailboards are mounted vertically at one end of the jig against the side stop. The scales are simply set to the thickness of the tailboard. The included template guide bush and bit follow the guide fingers and bridge piece material to form the tails. All tailboards are routed first. Then the finger assembly is rotated to access the pin guides. The finger assembly is now in the half-blind pin mode, as indicated by the scale icon. Once again, the scale is set on the thickness of the tailboard. Both modes, same setting. Half-blind pin boards are clamped horizontally in the jig against the top side stops. Whether the drawer fronts are flush or rabbeted makes no difference. Drawer front and drawer side alignment is guaranteed by the perfectly machined side stops. The drawer front pins are routed using the same dovetail bit at the same depth of cut as for the drawer side tails. The template guide bush and bit follow the parallel guide surfaces to form the pins. Precise fit for half-blind dovetails is achieved by adjusting the depth of cut. This is a router adjustment, not a jig adjustment. Here's why changing the depth of cut changes the fit in half-blind dovetails. Changing the depth of cut does not affect the width of the socket, but it does affect the width of the pin that goes into the socket. Decreasing the cutter depth narrows the pin, but the socket doesn't change. This produces a looser fit. Increasing the cutter depth makes the pin wider, but the socket width still doesn't change. This makes the fit tighter. All half-blind dovetail jigs work this way. Once the best fit is established, it's easy to measure and record the bit projection for a quick setup next time. Or for an equally quick setup, save your test piece. Leigh offers 5 different bit angles and depths of cut for half-blind dovetails to suit any drawer front thickness. Only Leigh dovetail jigs allow you to create this traditional handcrafted look with infinitely variable joint spacing, as on this beautiful chest of drawers.